Hello, my dear friends. This is Shweta Parmar once again welcomes you on the YouTube channel of Prabhat Exam. Today, we'll discuss about the tips to crack the UPSC examinations. So, if you are planning on preparing for the UPSC and CSE examinations, then you should remember one thing. There is no shortcut. There is no shortcut to hard work. There is no shortcut to success. So, it's important that you keep yourself motivated throughout the preparation process and stay focused and consistent. Remind yourself often why you choose to take up these examinations, why you choose to give these civil services examinations. So first, you have to ask yourself one question. Just ask yourself, can you clear the UPSC civil services examinations? And if the answer is yes, then just go for it. Because if you really know that you can do it, you certainly will do it. Because success only comes to those who know that they deserve it and that they'll do the hard work and nail it. So, dear friends, this is really true that being able to clear UPSC examinations depends on a person's will to hard work. This is an age where information is available in plenty and that too for free. So one can say with assurance that yes, it is possible to clear the UPSC examinations. And there are few candidates who are not taking any coaching classes. They are studying on their own also. So by self-study also you can clear it. But yes, a person should be hardworking, dedicated and organized. So now here I am with you. Just to share and to discuss a framework which you can use as a guideline to devise your preparation strategy. So the first thing which you have to gather is the required study material. Yes, my dear friends, because the very first thing is important to have what you have to study, as going through the exam syllabus will give you a brief idea about the kind of resources, the kind of study material which you have to take for yourself, which you will need for your preparations, which you need for your knowledge. Yes, so keep your sources minimal and follow the best sources available. So I should suggest few of the things, like follow government websites like Income Tax Department or the Ministry of Home Affairs or the Ministry of External Affairs, etc. Because for that authentic information, if you have that authentic information, you will know the basic guideline of the UPSC examinations. Because these websites are periodically updated with the latest information and annual reports are also available there. So if you have to gather and analyze previous year's UPSC examination paper also, then those exam questions which came in the previous year's UPSC exam will also help you. So at least like last 7 years examination papers you should gather and start gathering the real study material which you really need. Second thing, make a timetable. Yes, my dear friends, you have to make a timetable and set goals. You have to go through the UPSC CSE exam syllabus and then you have to set the sub goals to achieve the main goals. Because if you have to reach somewhere and if you have to reach a goal, then you have to make a certain sub goals for you which lead you towards the main goal. Okay, so divide the syllabus into topics and assign time for each topic. Like treat these as your sub goals, that you have assigned a topic and then from each topic also you have that certain time to prepare yourself. As you know, the time left for your preparation should be like the management time, because you have to make sure that the timetable covers the entire syllabus and leaves some time for revision also. So stick to your plan and follow it religiously for the rest of your preparation period. Thirdly, keep yourself up to date with current affairs. Yes, my dear friends, you know this, that being updated always needs very regular exercise of studying not only the books, not only the textbooks or the novels or the other magazines, but newspapers also. So it's highly important that you make a habit of reading a newspaper every day. Yes, I mean every day, because current affairs are a significant part of UPSC CSE exam. You should prefer newspapers over online websites also, because due to the accuracy issues, sometimes you have to go online and you have to read manually also. So if you want, then choose only very reliable source and proven websites if you have to go online only for the current affairs. But it's not enough to merely read the newspapers and remember the facts. It's equally important, I said, to analyze the information. So not only the magazine, not only the newspapers, not only other resources, but all in one you have to gather, and then you have to keep yourself updated with the current affairs. And you should have an opinion about it, that what is happening, when, what is happening, where, and what will be the results. So while UPSC is concerned about your knowledge of the facts, it is equally concerned about your opinions also on them. It's not only just like, okay, you have written, you have passed, and you just moved on. No. So practice mocks and measure performances also. It's important that you track your improvement and test your performance periodically, because it doesn't make sense to merely study and leave it just like that, because you know that you must test yourself to determine your speed and accuracy, to identify that in 1 week how much you have done, how much you go through the whole syllabus, how much you completed, and are you really going through the timetable? Yes, and if you are doing that, you can do these by taking the UPSC, USC mock test also, because the mock test tells you where you stand, what you'll do, and if you are doing everything very nicely. They check you, they test you, and they provide you your result in the mock, that you have to do more work there, and this has been done. Avoid too many distractions. Try to reduce your distractions so that you channel 95% of your attention towards your preparation. The social outings and hobbies are also needed, but majority of your attention is needed to prepare for these examinations, if you are really willing to give it and if you really want to crack it. You should understand, you should remember that UPSC CSE syllabus is very vast, and you should dedicate your time to it. Talk to your peers when you are preparing for the exam, because there is a chance that you will miss out on something very important. And to avoid this, it is very important that you network with your peers regularly, because they'll help you to prepare to your best, because they know what is coming, what type of questions are coming, what type of personality test you have to give, and what type of answers you have to write. So networking will give you an opportunity to exchange ideas, insights, and to preparation tips with your peers also. You get the preparation tips from your peers. You can discuss your preparation agenda with your peers, because it will also help you to reach out to the people when you have any doubts. They'll help you, they can clear you, and they can make you feel less lonely, thereby aiding your preparation. You should talk to the peers who are successful, or who are doing that, or who have cracked it, or who have even prepared for it, because they know what type of success strategies you have to do. So exchange your success strategies and struggles and common problems, and then you will find encouraging words for motivation. Don't forget to relax. Yes, my dear friends, the very important thing is to relax also, because your brain also need to relax. So while it is important to study at least for 6 to 8 hours every day, it is equally important that you make sure that you are getting sufficient sleep and you are well rested, because UPSC exam preparation can take months. But if you are not healthy mentally or physically, how will you give your exam so nicely? So it's very important that you don't overexhaust yourself and neglect your physical and mental well-being. So my dear friends, now we should conclude, and we should conclude by saying that yes, it is possible to prepare for UPSC CSE examinations from the heart and soul, and definitely you will crack it, because you are efficient, you are dedicated, and you are not only self-studying, but if you are taking coaching classes also, you are hardworking. And if you are hardworking, it will definitely pay out the success. So all the very best to all of you who are preparing for the examinations, and to those also who wanted to crack that examinations and who wanted to fight for that examinations, who are still in class 12th, but they want to go for the examinations. Because if you have that willpower, you will definitely crack it, because you have the caliber. So before waving all of you, just to remind you that keep connected on YouTube channel of Prabhat Exam, and yes, please subscribe if not yet done. Thank you so much.